people, 8 o'clock in the morning is time for getting up, getting dressed, and going. But to the kingfish, 8 a.m. is just a halfway mark in a good night's sleep. At least that's the way it was till this morning.
Bella, answer the telephone.
Answer the telephone, George.
Well, answer the door then.
It ain't the door. It's the alarm clock.
Alarm clock?
That's what it is. The reason you didn't recognize it is because you ain't heard it in 15 years.
Well, what do you mean, send that thing off this hour today? Scaring a man to death. I'll be so jumpy all day, I won't be able to hold a pool to you.
George, I made an appointment for you to see a man about a job. Now, get up.
Now, wait a minute, dear. You can't do that. It's an invasion of privacy. It's unconstitutional.
Here's your paint.
It's a violation.
Now, get up. And I'm telling you, George Stevens, if you don't take this job, you don't have to bother coming home tonight. Now, you go see Mr. Hanson, the sales manager of this insurance company. I think if there's one thing you can do, it's sell.
All right.
And here's 20 cents car fare. Make sure you go straight to the insurance company.
Well, where do you think I'm going on 20 cents, Honolulu?
So you see, Mr. Stevens, our hospitalization policy is easy to sell because it is very much in demand.
Yeah, sounds good, all right. But how much commission do I make?
10%. In other words, for every policy you sell for $50, you keep $5 and the company gets the $45.
Now, wait a minute here. Let's get this thing straight. If I sell the policy for $50... you get $45, and I don't get but $5.
That's right.
You're thinking here. Now, if I had my own insurance company, I could keep the whole $50 for myself. Couldn't I, Mr. Hanson?
What are you talking about?
And if I only sold policies to healthy people that ain't going to have no accidents, that would be 100% profit for me.
Just a minute, Mr. Stevens. What are you getting at?
Mr. Hanson, this is a wonderful country we're living in. I walked in here without a job. And 2 minutes later, I walk out, president of my own insurance company. Good day, sir.
Say, Kingfish, what's this sign on?
I'll be with you in a minute, Andy. Sit down and make yourself comfortable here.
Kingfish, what's this multi-million-dollar insurance company thing?
Oh, just what it say, Andy. I done multied myself up a few millionaires. And we've organized a hospitalization insurance company. Wait, I'll tell you more about it just soon as I finish making out these here claim checks to our policy holder. Let's see Mr. Harry Wingrove, sprain index finger, $867. James Montgomery, $264.82.
What happened to him?
Wait, let's see here. Oh, he nicked himself while shaving.
Holy smoke. Ain't that an awful lot of money, Kingfish?
Well, Andy, I know he padded it a little, but we don't check no claims under $1,000.
Yeah. Well, Kingfish, as long as you're busy, I'll go on out.
But wait a minute, Andy. It just recurred to me that you might be interested in taking out one of these hospitalization policies.
No, Kingfish. I wouldn't be interested.
But now look, Andy. The Stevens Hospitalization Insurance Company don't coax or use no high-pressure methods to sell anybody. Now, if a man says that he ain't interested, we respect his word.
All I want to know...
I'm glad you asked me, Andy. Now, there's some wonderful features about this here policy. You is protected from all accidents, even explosion and collision.
Yeah, well, what's the difference? You're dead either way, ain't you?
Yeah, but that makes a difference in the burial clause. We know what to do with you. Now, in a collision, there you is. But in an explosion, Well, yeah.
All right. But the only thing...
And that ain't the only feature of this here policy, Andy.
Kingfish, you hurt my foot.
Oh, I'm sorry, Andy. I didn't realize it. Now, Andy, let me give you a typical case. Now, suppose you're up in the Empire State Building, say, way up on the 79th floor.
Oh, that's high, all right.
And as you were leaning out the window, you loses your balance, and you fall from the 79th floor down to the sidewalk.
Well, what about it?
Then my company will pay you $15 a week benefit as long as you live.
They will, huh?
Yeah, and another nice little feature of this particular accident. The time and the payments don't start from the time you hit the sidewalk. They start from the time that you leave the window.
I earn money on the way down, huh? Listen, Kingfish, this sounds like a great policy, but I just ain't interested. I ain't never had no accident in my life.
But, Andy, suppose you don't have no accident. Suppose you just get sick and need an operation. If you take out one of our policies, we pay all your hospital bills, medicine, and everything. Lightning?
I left my broom over in the corner there. I wonder could I get a place here?
Yeah, Lightning, come on. Hurry on over there and get it, and then get on out of here. And now, Andy? Well, how do you like that? The dirty prospect sneaked out on me.
Did you tell McNally my insurance policy, Mr. Kingfish?
No, Lightning. Andy said he ain't sick, ain't gonna be sick, ain't gonna have no accidents or nothing. Oh, me.
I guess nobody wants to buy hospitalization insurance when they're feeling good. The only time a person wants to buy a policy is when they think they're gonna be sick.
Lightning, I think you done give me an idea.
Idea? I must be smarter than I think I am. What you gonna do with that, Mr. Kingfish?
Lightning, do you remember the large brother who was taking his examination for X-ray technician?
Yes, sir.
Well, there's an X-ray he took of me when he was just practicing.
Is that you, Mr. Kingfish?
Yeah, that's me, all right. You look down there. Even the initial on my belt buckle come through. G.S.
George Stevens.
Yes, sir. Lightning. This could be anybody's X-ray. Even Andrew H. Brown.
Any mail for me, Lightning?
No, sir, Mr. Andy. Ain't no mail for you.
Well, I tell you, Lightning, I'm
glad you dropped in, Andy.
I tell you, I ain't interested in no hospitalization insurance.
Look, Andy, I wouldn't sell you a policy if you obeyed me. I got more business than I can take care of. And the only reason that I'm happy to see you, I want to try out my new X-ray equipment.
X-ray equipment?
Yeah, Andy, my company is doing such a tremendous business that we ain't got time to send the prospects out to be X-rayed. So from now on, I'm going to take them myself.
And you just want me to help you test the thing?
That's all, Andy.
Well, there ain't no harm in that, I guess.
Well, Andy, come right on over into the X-ray department.
This the X-ray machine?
Yeah, Andy, this is one of the new small types, like they use in the Millionaire Brothers clinic.
Oh.
Yeah, now stand right over here, son. Stand right there, and we try the machine out. Yeah, see how it works here. Sure is dark in there. Andy, open your mouth so we can get a little more light down there.
Perfect.
Thanks very much, Andy. I'll just run into the dark room and develop the thing. Beautiful, Andy.
This the picture you just took?
Yeah, Andy, I'd have been back soon, only I had to enlarge it.
Have it for a souvenir.
I'll take it home with you.
Thanks, Kingfish.
Holy mackerel.
What's wrong, Kingfish?
Oh, nothing at all, Andy. I'll think nothing of it. But on second thought, I'll just tear it up. Forget the whole thing.
Hey, Kingfish, what's going on here?
Andy, I don't know how to say this, but since you is my best friend, there's something I got to tell you. Make the most of the next few months.
There's something wrong with me, and you is my best friend, and you got to tell me what it is.
All right, Andy. Come over here and sit down on the couch. Let me help you.
Yeah.
I don't know where to start at. This looks like a 9-car wreck.
Kingfish, what is this down here at the bottom that looks like a belt buckle?
Well, Andy, that's the root of your trouble. And that ain't no belt buckle. That's part of your anatomy.
Yeah, but what's that GS for?
Oh, the GS. Oh, yeah, that stands for gallstone.
Gallstone? I thought you knew it when you had them things.
Oh, not all the time, Andy, but tell me this. Do you eat many mashed potatoes?
Yeah, I eat a lot of them.
Well, that's the reason you didn't know you had the gallstone. The mashed potatoes keep them from rattling. Well, Andy, I don't see no sense in going any further with the diagnosis. Just a good thing that I didn't sell you on them hospitalization policies.
You mean I can't get one of them now?
Oh, no, Andy. I can't do business with anybody as discreet as you is.
Listen, Kingfish, you just got to get me one of them policies. Because if I got to go, I want to go with the best of care.
I know that, Andy, but...
Please, Kingfish.
Well, it's again the company's policy, Andy. But as you is my best friend, I'll take you in. Now, that'll be $50. Now, let me help you up so you can get to your wallet.
Oh. Andy, what happened to you in there?
Amos, I was in bad shape.
What's wrong? What's the matter with you?
It's a serious thing, Amos. Look at that. My gallstones were in a 9-car wreck with some mashed potatoes.
I don't know what you're talking about, Andy. But when I saw you this morning, you felt like $1 million.
Yeah, well, that just goes to show how fast a man can fall apart. I'm going home and wait for the end.
Oh, wait a minute, Andy. I don't know what's wrong with you, but if you're as sick as you act, you ought to go see a doctor.
I think it's too late, Amos. I feel like they're rigging up my mortars already.
Don't be silly, Andy. There's a doctor about 4 blocks over. Come on, hop in the cab. I'll drive you over there myself.
Well, all right, Amos. Help me.
Well, I'll tell you, Mr. Brown, I've given you a fairly thorough examination. And frankly, I can't find anything wrong with you.
Well, then, Doctor, you ain't looked in the right places, because I is a sick man.
Well, I have no explanation for the way you feel. But I admit, there's a peculiar aspect in this case that I want to look into. And on top of that, I do want to make some additional tests. So suppose you come back tomorrow morning and we'll go into this further.
If you don't mind, Doctor, I'd rather go right to the hospital, because I need a lot of medical care bad.
Well, actually, there's no need of your going to the hospital until we know more about your condition.
Look, Doctor, I is a bachelor, and I ain't got no one to look after me. And in the hospital, I might have a chance to recover.
Well, I guess there's no harm in having your test made there. And furthermore, I'm very much concerned about this high state of nervousness you're in.
Yes. In fact, it might be a lot more convenient if you did go to the hospital.
Thank you, Doc. Thank you, sir.
All right, Mr. Brown.
Georgie, now you can be real comfortable.
Oh, thank you, honey. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Oh, George, I'm so proud of you. Earning $50 on the first day.
Yeah, honey, you got a live wire for a husband, all right.
I paid off the butcher, the grocery store, and some of the rent. Oh, George, it's so wonderful having money come in.
Yeah, honey, it sure is.
George, there's one thing I don't understand. You turned down that job with the insurance company that I sent you to, but you're still in the insurance business.
Yeah, honey, I made different arrangements, and everything's going to work out fine. Yeah, I made arrangements where I'm going to make double the profits on each deal. Oh, it's going to be great.
Well, George, I certainly... You get the telephone. I got some hump soap.
Hello? Who? Andy? You'll have to talk louder. Where are you, in a telephone booth?
No, Kingfish. I was in the hospital.
In the hospital? That's nice. Hospital? What are you doing down there?
I ain't here for test and examination. I was a sick man, Kingfish. I just called to tell you to start that insurance stuff, but I'm going to need a lot of money.
Calhoun, do you mean to say that I got to pay all of the bills?
Well, now, Kingfish, as a bona fide personal consultant, I'd say that you is responsible. That boy can sue you.
Oh, me. Calhoun, the thing that's killing me is Andy ain't sick. I scared him into it.
Oh, now, Kingfish, there ain't a human being in their right mind gonna be in no hospital when they're feeling good. Why, it just don't make... where was we?
You were talking about Andy being sick.
He is? Well, where is he? Oh, yeah. I remember now. Like I was saying, Andy wouldn't be in no hospital if he wasn't really sick, because there ain't a man on the face of the earth would be laying in no hospital when he could be walking around outside. After all, even Andy up there...
Calhoun, will you please keep your mind on the business at hand?
Oh, yeah. Well, now, like I was telling you, knowing how scared Andy is of doctors, you can be sure he's good and sick if he upstairs in bed. As a matter of fact, anybody who didn't have to go to the hospital would be crazy to go there if they didn't. Kingfish, what do you have to do to get in a place like this?
Calhoun, will you take your mind off the opposite gender and buckle down here to my problem?
Yeah. Well, let's see here. According to what you told me, you scared Andy into the hospital.
That's right.
Well, there you is. You got your answer right there. Scare him out of here.
Well, how am I going to do it?
Well, I don't know, Kingfish. With your normal common sense thinking and my scintillating brilliant mind, we ought to be able to come up with a pretty dirty idea.
Wait a minute,
Kingfish. I've got it. And I'll even help you put the thing across. Now, here's what we're going to do. First, you go up there.
Hi, Andy.
Oh, hi, Kingfish.
Well, how you feeling, son?
Oh, I'm going to be all right, I guess. I hope your insurance company ain't so at me for going to the hospital right after I took out one of the policies.
Oh, don't be silly, Andy. It happens all the time. We expect it. But the multi-$1 million insurance company takes a philosophical view of the whole thing.
Yeah, well, that's good.
Well, Andy, I just dropped up here to go over a few little details about your confinement here. You know, our main concern is to protect the interests of our policyholders. I want to see if this hospital's on the approved list. Olympic Hospital. Yeah, it's on the approved list, all right.
Yeah, well, I'm glad to hear that, all right.
Now, Andy, who is your doctor?
Dr. Joseph Wilkins.
Let's see, doctor, let's see if he's on the approved list. Watson, Weston, Wilson. Yeah, here we are, Andy. Dr. Joseph Wilkins.
Is he approved, Kingfish?
Yeah, Andy, you sure picked a good one. Better look at his background here. Academic work taken at USC. Medical course, 4 years at UCLA. 4 years of surgery at CSH.
I heard about them other two, but what is CSH?
Chicago Slaughterhouse.
You mean I didn't pick myself a doctor instead of the slaughterhouse?
Well, what's wrong with that? Any doctor that's good enough for the Longhorns ought to be good enough for you.
Yeah, maybe you're right about that, all right. Only thing is, Kingfish, I was a little squeamish about having a car doctor.
But, Andy, look on the bright side. Now, in case you got hoof or mouth disease, he is the one man that will know how to locate it.
Yeah, you're right about that.
Yeah, now, getting back to your doctor here. Yeah, and you ain't got nothing to worry about. Yeah, he's an outstanding man.
He is, huh?
Yeah, he graduated CSH Magna Cum Sorta. Yeah, he was a top man in his class, hacking and slicing.
Yeah, well, I'm glad I'm only here for tests and examination, because it ain't never come to none of that hacking and slicing. Dr. Wilkins going to be here in about 15 minutes.
Yes?
Yeah.
Calhoun. Calhoun!
Well, if it ain't of all the... Well, look who... What's going on here?
Well, I come up to see Andy. He's sick.
Now, ain't that a coincidence? I just got a job here in this hospital as orderly. I'm assigned to Dr. Wilkins, and they tell me they got to make some tests in here.
Yeah, that's right. He's going to test me. Gee, I'm so glad somebody I know is going to be around.
Yeah, I'll be with you all the time. Because they tell me Dr. Wilkins got to make quite a few tests.
The doctor's going to use the same instrument that he used at good old CFH.
Huh?
What's the doctor going to do with this stuff?
I don't know, Andy. Your guess is as good as mine.
Be with you in a minute, Andy.
Kingfish, what you think the doctor gonna use all this stuff for?
Well, Andy, I don't know too much about it, but just offhand, I say he's gonna give you a metabolism test.
Yeah, but what's the nice,
but... Oh, be sensible, Andy. Do you know where your metabolism is?
No.
Well, neither do the doctor. They're just gonna slash around until they find it.
Fish, I didn't know it was going to be nothing like this. I thought all the doctor was going to do was make some...
Sorry, Andy, we might have to tie you down.
What for?
We ran out of ether.
Yeah, Fish, you hold this up there by his head, will you? What do they say?
6 foot even, Calhoun.
I guess we better make it 6'6". They might want him to wear his derby. See you later, Andy. I got to go see the carpenter now.
Kingfish, I ain't
going, gentlemen.
Doctor. Dr. Wilkins.
Well, I wonder what got into him.
Doctor, it looked like you done lost the patient. I can't see for the world what made the boy act up like that. Must be the nervous type.
His preliminary test showed nothing wrong, but I did want to speak to him about this x-ray. You know, this is not the x-ray of Mr. Brown.
Well, you don't mean to tell me. Well, if it ain't hidden, I don't guess it's important.
It's very important. I'd want to know whose x-ray this really is, because this man has a bad case of gallstones that needs immediate surgery.
Oh, doctor.